Hey everyone, it's your boy Graphic back with another video, and today we're going to be looking at episode 3 of Albion Online PvP 2v2 Hellgates. We got the Great Curse staff again with the Druidic staff builds, and we're going to go over both builds real quick before we get started on some of the highlights and we commentate over a few of them. So we got the Expert's Great Curse staff 5.1 on the Great Curse staff build, and we're going to be going Vile Curse to get those stacks automatically, the click. And instead of the skill shot, just to automatically get those hits. Then we're going to also go the Grudge, which gives you a lot more damage over time as well with the Vile Curse and the Grudge. We're going to go the Area of Decay, obviously, as it is the only ability we can really go here. And it's very strong. And then we're going to be going Furious. Furious or Bane can both work. I like to go Furious. Get that extra damage on the skills when you get 5 activated, pretty strong. And then you'll see I have Mage Cow. I will be going poison on the head, and I will be going aggression for the extra damage and heal power. I'll be going purging shield and damage slash heal power on the mage robe. And then we have the guardian boots, and I will be going giant and toughness. And that'll complete my build. As you can see, this is my build with the beef stew and the major poison pots. And I'll go like a tier 4 cape, or you can go a martlock cape if you'd like to go a little bit more expensive. If we had more failures as a team of 2, I would try that out. But really, we haven't lost with this build too often when it's me and him. So his build as a healer, a nature healer, or druidic healer, I guess. We have the expert druidic staff, which he runs. Rejuvenation, and he runs Protection of Nature, and then obviously the Spiritual Seed and the Adrenaline Driven Charity. And that is Mistcaller. He runs a 5.1 Mistcaller, very strong. Adept's Fiend Robe 4.2, and he runs the Fear Aura, which is very, very important. Fear Aura might be one of the most important abilities out of this whole build. It's how you win fights. And then you have the Aggression. He increases damage and heal power by 8%, very strong as well. And then we'll have the Adept's Mercenary Hood, which gives you a cleanse that can actually cleanse all allies in close proximity, which is huge for cleansing me and him if he uses it correctly. Very good skill, very important hood. You can go a couple others as well, but we like to stick with the Mercenary Hood. Then we have Balanced Mind, increases your damage and heal power by 1.5%, and incoming damage is reduced by 90.99%. And then he also goes Guardian Boots for the Giant, very strong, the Giant and the Toughness. So that is his build, and he also has the Lamhurst Cape, which activates, when he's below energy 40% and restores 8% energy per 10 seconds. This is basically so if he gets a big drop or anything, he can actually run around and survive in the dungeon by himself. If we get a big drop and we have an unfortunate encounter or something of that nature, usually it doesn't actually come in handy, but we do have it there in case. And he is running a resist pot, and I am running a poison pot, just the highest you can go. 8.1 and 7.1, you can go those as well, not a big difference, but you can upgrade if you'd like. He goes a pork omelet for the cooldown reductions and casting times, and I go the beef stew for the actual combat damage. And this is basically our builds for this montage of clips. So if you guys want to try to replicate something like it, take a look. And obviously you're going to be overcharging with the siphoned energy. I didn't want to forget that. Some of you guys are new and don't understand how overcharging works. Basically, overcharging works to where every time you use an overcharge, these four items, the main four items, have a chance of destroying when the overcharge is up in 30 minutes. So after 30 minutes, they are basically buffed by, I think it's like 200 item power or something. It's basically a very strong buff to all of the items on you. However, they have a chance after 30 minutes to break. I believe it's a 15% chance after 30 minutes to break, and that can cost you a good amount of silver. So make sure you're using your time wisely, and most of the time, you'll definitely make profit doing Hellgates as long as you're winning. So thanks guys for tuning in today, and I hope you guys like the next little bit of clips as I commentate over them a little bit for you guys. Alright guys, so we're starting out with the 2v2. It looks like we're playing against a Warbow with his E coming out there, not doing much damage, as the Warbow's not really a great pick in twos. This guy might be running a Claymore. I can't really tell. No, he's not running a Claymore. He's got dual weapons there. But either way, they're not doing much damage for running dual weapons and no healer. So Alpha is a little bit weak, but you know that's not gonna continue and last long when he's running the Druidic. So he gets the we end up getting a kill on one of them, and this will just be an eventual chase sort of thing with the Warbow. As I'm just kind of waiting on Alf to get the loot real quick, and after he's done looting, we go in hot on the last guy running, looks like to be a Warbow, like I said earlier. So I do get some two stacks, I think, from my E there, which is allowing that damage to come out a lot faster. Here we're looking like we're playing against some black hands and a what seems to be a great holy staff of some sort. So what we're going to do is focus the damage here for sure, because he does so much damage. Black Hands is one of the strongest, you know, builds out there in Hellgates right now. There's definitely a ton of builds that are useful and are able to win Hellgates, but usually you need a healer, and usually Black Hands is on the other side of it. So Black Hands is just devastating for a lot of teams right now. So right now, it looks like we're playing against maybe a Claymore and a Nature Staff. What we're going to do here is Alf's going to split them up so crazy far away that this guy's going to get a lot of damage dealt to him without his healer being able to really pop them heals yet. So we're going to end up getting this guy with damage over time, which is about a good 50k fame. And now we're going to move on to the next fight. We got a what seems to be somewhat like a mace jumping in, getting a good root stun or whatever it's called. And he's got the Thetford cape on. In the back lines, I believe. So we're going to focus him in the back. We're going to go straight on the Drake Hammer, and I'm going to get a lot of good damage down right here as he uses his Fear and tries to push me away. And we're going to keep this damage going now onto the next guy on the melee. Another thing you'll notice is we don't really lose two damage dealers ever. I know I only show you guys the wins, but there was a good 172k fame. I only do show you guys the wins for your guys' sake, but we really do not lose to two damage dealers almost ever, and so you pretty much have to go a healing staff unless you're willing to risk a 7.1 or higher for that extra damage. You just really need to risk a lot to damage players at that level to where that you can insta-kill them or you can damage past the healer. But here we got a pretty good kill on both of these players as they were running a decent build, a decent comp, and we get about 160k fame there total, so not bad at all. Here we're going to be trying to clear bats for this fight, and I think they're going to come in before we're able to clear the bats. This guy's trying to shoot some arrows at us and things, and that doesn't usually seem to work as the bows don't have any place in Hellgates, it seems, right now. So the bows themselves trying to be used in Hellgates is just probably not the play, as I get a lot of damage down on that guy, and eventually he's going to die for 50k fame, and I'm just going to kind of chase this bow guy down at this point. It's really a struggle right now in Hellgates, and, you know, it's a bummer because I do like the bows. I have them leveled up a little bit, but eventually we do kill him. And now we're on to a, looks like to be a, I can't even tell what that is right now, but he is a hammer in a way at the very least. It might be some axe of some sort. I have the screen a little bit smaller when I am casting these kills, so it's hard to kind of see some of these times, so I need to probably figure that out for the next episode for you guys. But yeah, we got four stacks on him right now, and Al's able to push him away a couple times, and this is going to be a long, long fight, actually. I remember this fight, and it was a very evenly matched fight with sustain. Their healer was doing a great job as well as our healer, and he was able to just keep putting stacks and keep putting stacks. What I could have done to kind of fix this is I could have put stacks onto the healer as well, and that would have made him have to heal himself as well and maybe kind of ruin his stacks a little bit. As, you know, the unit is Koduck is actually hitting both of us, and that kind of hurts us because Alf's got to heal himself and heal me. So right here we're just trying to kind of kite, and I get a very big heavy E on them and apply a lot of stacks and damage, and that's gonna kill Koduck, and then eventually obviously we're gonna kill the healer. So it's just all about that E popping off as well, making sure you're getting a lot of hits with that E. Here we're playing another strong team, playing a Black Hands player, which, like I said, Black Hands is just very, very strong right now in the Hellgates. So they are a very costly item as well, so you know, risking it in Hellgates means usually that you kind of know what you're doing, because usually players don't like their risk items in Hellgates if they don't know how to use them. So right here we do get a good kill onto the Black Hands player, as he was just kind of hammering away with this guy right here. And we're going to eventually kill this guy, too. He's just going to do a couple more circles with us, it seems like. So right there, he's going to finally kind of bleed out or, you know, damage over time, takes over. And right here, it looks like we're playing against a Bolt Casters and a Nature Healer or maybe a Great Holy Staff. But basically, we get a good combo right there of fearing, and I just completely erase this kid while Alf gets that good fear. So this guy's going to book it out of there, and we will eventually probably kill him. And right here, it looks like we got a Druidic Staff and a melee DPS, which isn't really a problem because, you know, we run straight through the bats and kind of disrespect them in general right there by just running through the bats and understanding that we're probably just going to kill them anyway. So it's not a big deal. But yeah, we got a lot of damage down right there, and now we're going to be chasing the Druidic Healer across the map and eventually killing him as well over here while he gets chased. He tries to heal up in front of the bats. Not a great place to heal as you're just going to get extra damage down, so your heals are going to do less. But he is able to heal up to full health, and eventually I'm going to get enough stacks while he's just autoing away, and I'm going to toss an E down and kill him. So he was running some decent gear as well. Right here, it looks like we have a guy trying to frontline at us, and the crossbow is just, it's good right now for sure. Definitely a strong item. But they are some reason running a crossbow and a great holy, which is, I don't think it's going to do enough damage. It's got burst for sure, but it doesn't have enough damage to out-damage the Druidic Heal, in my opinion, as he almost gets Alf, though. This was a really good fight because you could tell that they knew what they were doing, though, the way they were playing it. And you'll actually notice once we do actually come out on top of this fight, it is an eventual come out on top as they do know what they're doing pretty well. They played it pretty well themselves. But, yeah, they were worth a good 120k fame as they ran multiple dungeons in a row or Hellgates in a row as they had a lot of confidence and figured they were just going to bank after a few more runs. So you got to love beating those players that have you know, full inventory as well as good loot on top of them. So we get a lot of damage dealt onto that guy as he tries to run away. Obviously not going to work as I'm running the Great Curse and just apply a lot of DOT to the player. And for those of you who don't know, DOT is damage over time. And right here, we're just kind of stacking up on this guy as he is trying to just out-heal, or not out-heal, but kind of just out-survive. And obviously that's not going to happen as well as he eventually drops. And we have our last fight of the day with two players. One guy's already weak for some reason. This guy's running a bloodletter and he's pretty weak. And we're just going to kind of focus on this guy on the side as the guy that's weak is not even attacking us. And Alf gets a decent fear to keep him off me. And this guy goes ice block, which is no problem. I'll just switch targets. This guy heals up a little bit, but it's not a problem because after damage dealers use their healing and defensive abilities, they have no more for like, 60 seconds? So it's really not a big deal. We'll end up killing his teammate, and I'll go giant for him here to get that movement speed and track him down. I hope you guys liked today's video, and I'll see you guys next time.